ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover. All I
ever wanted. This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't want to meet you. Just give me my motherfucking check.
We're going to be located at the Westchester County Center, 198 Central Ave, right Plains, New York, 10606. $100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free. Start sending in your funds today. For booking information, check us out on the ISUPK 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commandant General Yohana will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. The Lord's 51st Annual Passover.
Shalom, Israel. We are the ISUPK out of 1 West 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commanding General Yohana. We are not affiliated with any religious group or organization. We are here today to show you all here in Trinidad, here in Port of Spain, that the so-called black man, so-called Hispanic man, so-called Native Indian man is from the 12 lost tribes of the nation of Israel. We are here in this small island. Most of us don't even know who we are. Black man, Hispanic man. The East Indian know who he is. The Chinese man know who he is. The so-called white man know who he is.
Right.
The so-called Syrian know who he is. But the black man has no idea who he is. The black man only know he came here as a slave. That is all they teach you, black man. And they don't care about you. When you die in the streets, they laugh. When you get shot in the streets, they laugh. They say another blackhead chicken dead. Another blackhead chicken. They watch us as nothing. When we kill each other, they laugh.
That's right.
What they say, one less. Huh? They laugh us to scorn. We are on the streets. They call us good for nothing. Our commissioner of police call us pests and cockroach and ants. How could you watch my people and call them a cockroach? How could you watch my people and call them a pest?
That's right.
How could you laugh and smile when my brother lay in the street with his brains on the ground? How could I love to see my brother kill another brother? For what? For Rasta City? For Muslim? How could I love that? While the Chinese man laughing,
right.
The Indian man laughing,
that's right.
The Syrian man laughing,
that's
when
right.
We kill each other in the streets. But guess what? The Christian pastor is loving everybody. God loves everybody. God loves everybody. That's what the Christian pastor say. But the Christian pastor does not know the Bible. The Christian pastor does not understand this Bible.
That's right.
The Christian pastor will try to understand, will try to fool you. But we will show you that your Christian pastor is a liar. Your Christian pastor is a thief.
That's right.
Your Christian pastor does not have the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
Your Christian pastor will tell you God loves everybody. But that is not true. We will prove to you today that your pastor is a liar.
That's right.
Deuteronomy 4:6. Keep therefore and do them. For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations.
Keep therefore and do them. What this passage of scripture is talking about is about the laws the commandments that the Most High gave to the nation of Israel. These laws and these commandments was not given to no other people. This Bible was given to the so-called black man.
That's right.
So-called Hispanic man. So-called Native Indian man.
That's right.
This Bible does not belong to no other group of people.
Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 6. Keep therefore and do them.
What?
For this is your wisdom.
What?
And your understanding in the sight of all of the nations.
This Bible, these laws in this Bible, black man, is your wisdom for all the nation to see. When you keep these laws in this Bible, black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man, all of the nation will wonder your wisdom, your knowledge, and your understanding.
That's
but
right.
Your Christian pastor will tell you that the laws of God are done away with. Your Christian pastor will tell you, God love everybody, you're saved by grace. But that is not in the Bible.
That's right.
Your Christian pastor will tell you that everything in this book, in the Old Testament, is done away with, which is a lie.
Right. That's right.
Your Christian pastor is a goddamn liar.
Right. Right.
And we're going to prove it. And we're going to show where the Most High is making your pastor a liar.
That's right.
Because the truth is not in him. Go ahead.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 17. Think not I am come to destroy the law.
Think not that you have come to destroy the law.
Go ahead. Or the prophets.
Go ahead.
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
He has not come to destroy, but to fulfill. This is written in red. This is our King, Yahawashi, who the world calls Jesus Christ. He is saying that all the laws that the prophets, that Moses gave, and all the other prophets after Moses, when all these laws were given, these laws were given to us as a people.
What? Verse 18. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass,
till heaven and earth pass,
one jot or one tittle shall no wise pass from the law.
Now the heaven is here, the earth is here. How the hell your Christian pastor can tell you the laws of God are done away with?
Right.
When the Bible clearly shows you that when heaven disappear and the earth disappear, then the laws of God are done away with. Your Christian pastor is a liar.
That's right.
We're going to see and prove here today that you're one, that your pastor is a liar. And two, that he does not know what is the Holy Spirit, and he does not have the Holy Spirit. These men standing here of the ICPK under commanding General Yohana, these men here have the Holy Spirit. And we're going to show you in this Bible what is the Holy Spirit.
Right.
Go ahead.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
For thou art a holy people before the Lord thy God. Holy means to be separate. You can have a holy cup. You can have a holy shoes. The Most High has a holy people, a separate people, a people above everybody else. To be holy is to be separate from everything else. Go ahead.
The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
The Most High God has chosen the children of Israel to be a special people, God,
above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above all people on the face of the earth. Now, if God, the Most High God in the Bible, who said we are above all the nations of the earth, how could your Christian pastor say God loves everybody? We are proving that your pastor is a liar.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art a holy people unto the Lord thy God.
For thou art a holy people of the Lord thy God.
Go ahead. The Lord thy God hath chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
The Lord has chosen the nation of Israel to be a special people above what?
Unto himself.
Unto himself. Go ahead.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above the Chinese.
Above all people of the face of the earth.
Above the East Indian.
Above all people on the face of the earth.
Above the African.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
Above the so-called white man.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
The Most High has chosen one group of people above every other race on the planet. That race of people is the nation of Israel.
That's right.
Who is the so-called black man, so-called Hispanic man, so-called Native Indian man. If anybody want to dispute that, look in the Bible.
Verse 7, the Lord did not send his love upon you, nor choose you, because you were more in numbers than any people.
We are the children of Israel here. Wherever we go, we in the bottom. We in John, we in Sealots, we in the beat-up, we in Point, we in Labre. Every single ghetto is a black ghetto.
Right.
Show me the Chinese ghetto. Show me the East Indian ghetto.
That's right.
Show me the white man ghetto. Where is it, black man? Only you alone in the ghetto, black man. You alone. When we die in the streets, they mock us, they laugh at us. What do? They have all the banks, all the groceries, all the shops, all the hardwares. We continue to be slaves. Every single one of us have to work for every other nation here on the planet.
That's right.
Every time we die, they put us and parade us on the TV. Another little black boy with a gun. But yet again, there was a high-profile guy, high-profile. They find guns in his house. We have today, if you are found with a gun, it's an unbailable offense. Every little black boy found with a gun now, he's in jail. But yet still, when you go in Westmoreland, a certain high-profile man's son was found with guns, and he gets bail. Who is you, black man? This land's law is not for you.
Right.
This law here in Trinidad is against you. You have to follow the laws of your forefathers, who is Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. We are seeing today that we're going to continue to show you here that you are being lied to by your Christian pastor. And you are going to be destroyed listening to your Christian pastor in this church.
Amos 3, verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth.
Now this is the prophet Amos. Amos is giving a prophecy. Here's what Amos is saying to this group of people. Amos is showing and proving that the Most High God only loves one group of people.
Amos chapter 3 verse 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
He did not say this to the Chinese man, to the East Indian. He did not say this to the African. What?
Saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth.
The God of Israel said, you only have I known. Who tell you, black man, you is African? Who tell you is African? The white man tell you is African? You don't even know. This Bible tells you who you are. Don't let nobody tell you who you are. Black man, you are not an African. You are not Hispanic. You are not a Native Indian. You are from the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right.
What?
Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
He said he will punish you alone, black man. Hispanic man, Native Indian man. Look who is dying in the streets, black man. Look who is getting gunned down. Look who is in poverty. Look who is in distress. Look who is getting all the low-end jobs. Look who is being fired. Look who is lying on the streets. We're going to continue to see that the so-called black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man is continually being oppressed.
Right.
They bring laws to destroy us. The other day they passed a law, what they call it, the Zessa law. A black man can't wear a gold chain no more? You telling me a black man cannot look good? They ain't bringing no law for all those white hardware and washing money, washing all the drug money in the hardware. They ain't doing that. But when a black man wear a gold chain, they bring a Zessa law. That is, declare your assets. All these people who have land, all this big hardware, they come from nothing, and all of a sudden they're big. They bring in the law for them. But a black man wear a gold chain, they bring a Zessa law for him.
That's right.
The black man has no peace in this place.
Right.
The Hispanic man has no peace. Where's your land, black man? You have to go and squat. You're in the ghetto.
Psalm 147, verse 19. He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgment unto Israel. Verse 20. He had not dealt so with any nation.
He had not dealt so with any nation. Because you're going to see that the Most High is punishing one group of people only. The so-called black man, so-called Hispanic man, so-called Native Indian man. We are suffering the most in this country. Wherever we are, we suffer while all other nations are on top of us. The Chinese man is on top. Every Chinese come here, he come here with a whole grocery one time.
That's right.
Where your grocery, black man? The East Indian come here with a bag of wealth. When the Fatal Razak came here, they came here as indentured laborers.
Right.
They came here with land. They get paid. What you get, black man? Licks. The Chinese man come here, everything set. The African man come here, he come here set. The East Indian come here, he come here set. What you have, black man? The white man come here, the Syrian come here. Caroni lands. All our foreparents' bones are buried in Caroni.
Right.
Where the black man land in Caroni?
That's right.
Tell me. Where's the black man land in Pinal?
Right.
Nebe.
Right.
Chogonas.
That's right.
But the black man get what? In Sealots. We get lands in the sea. We don't even have land. In the Bitab. In the Congo. Lavantel. We are living in shacks. And what do they give? What do they give us? Guns. What little black boy have guns? Or in fact, what little black boy have money to bring guns?
That's right.
But yet we have our gold chain on our neck. And I want to take that too. The black man has no peace. And your Christian pastor is a liar and a thief. $29 million. But we see lots suffering. John. And they call us cockroach and pests.
Psalm 147 verse 20. He had not dealt so with any nation. And as for his judgments, they have not known them.
As for his judgment, they have not known them. Only the nation of Israel is being punished today.
That's right.
The so-called black man is being punished. Black on black crime, drugs, diseases, poverty, you name it. Everything under the sun, the black man suffering.
Right.
Who is being punished more? Who fills up the jail? Black man. How much Chinese is seen in jail? Or they tell me, how much Chinese men are they seen in jail? How much East Indian is seen in jail? How much white man is seen in jail? Only black people full of the jail. Because of why? Black on black crime. Because we do not love each other, black man.
Right.
Love your people first, black man. Before you love anybody else.
ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't wanna meet you. Just give me my motherfucking
check. We're gonna be located at the Westchester Town Center, 198 Central Ave, right Plains, New York, 10606. $100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free. Start sending in your funds today. But do they trust for booking information, check us out on the ISUPK 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commander General Yohanan will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. The Lord's 51st Annual Passover.